Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. Oh goodness, in this episode, I am going to attempt to convince you that all of your small integer operations are broken. This episode of C++ Weekly is sponsored by me. Be sure to check out the video description for important links about upcoming events, sponsoring the channel with Patreon, buying copies of my best practices and puzzler books, and how to contact me if you are interested in on-site training or remote code reviews. Okay, so depending on your perspective, you are either going to be surprised or not that 0 minus 1 in this example returns minus 1. Generally speaking, if we see 0 minus 1, we kind of expect that to be a result of negative 1, right? That's not really surprising. But these are unsigned uint 8t. So let's look at it this way. If I do it this way, I get 255 returned. And that's because an unsigned 8-bit integer is simply going to wrap back around. This is defined behavior. If I take 0 and subtract 1, it's going to go to max int for its size, which is positive 255. And that's probably what you were expecting to see if you were familiar with unsigned integer arithmetic and you use these small integers. So what happens though if I change this type to auto? I'm back to having negative 1 as my result. And this is incredibly frustrating to me. The reason here is because of the result of subtracting two unsigned 8-bit integers. So what we can see is this little I right here. This is an int. The result of subtracting two uint8t's is an int. And I can, with a static assert here, ask the compiler, is in fact the type of the result int? And it is. This compiles. Well, surely you would use this as an argument to not use auto, but it gets worse. Let's just say I want to go ahead and not use auto. I'm going to be smart. And now the compiler is not going to compile this because the type of result is no longer int. That's good. Let's just comment that out. And we can see for our own curiosity's sake here that this is h, is the mangled name of uint8t. It's the same as an unsigned car. Now, I have lots of warnings enabled in my code, warnings that I know most of you don't have enabled. Because you see something like this and you're like, I don't care. This is a conversion from an int to uint8t, whatever, do your job, compiler. So you are going to disable dash w conversion. And if you're paying attention, you'll see here that the compiler has continued to return 255. Why the heck is it returning 255? It should be returning 255 divided by 2, right? Because if I have 0 minus 1, I get negative 1, or 255 for uint8t, I do a right shift by 1 bit, I should get 255 divided by 2. That's what a right shift does. I can do a right shift by 3. Any idea what I'm going to get? I'm going to get 255 again. The only way to get this to give me the correct answer is to make this a uint8t and then do the shift right. Because this implicit promotion to an int right here means that all of these shift rights were doing an arithmetic shift right on most CPUs. An arithmetic shift right does a sign extend of the sign bit on the leftmost position. So let's go ahead and illustrate this really quickly. If I have a signed integer that is represented by these 7 bits, and I want to do a right shift by 1, we're going to get this result. And that is because it's going to maintain its current sign in the case of a signed integer. If, on the other hand, I have unsigned, and I do something like this, and try to shift this by 1 to the right, then I get this result. And this is the exact behavior that we're seeing. If I don't have this explicit static cast right here, I may as well be just saying this is an integer. An integer is a signed number, and it's going to do this signed or integer arithmetic on the shift right, and it is going to extend that sign bit. But that's not what I wanted. I wanted to actually do unsigned integer arithmetic, because that's what I expected was the result of subtracting 2 unsigned integers from each other. That should be an unsigned value. This is defined behavior in the standard. I want to maintain that defined behavior. The compiler says, no, you actually want signed integer arithmetic. So if we go back, we have more levels of pain. Okay, good. We actually don't have any extra pain at the moment. That is nice to see. But it is not unexpected that you might actually end up having to do things like this throughout your code base to actually get the correct result. So right now, if you do not have wconversion enabled and you're doing arithmetic on small integer types, things that have these implicit promotions to int, then your code is probably broken. You probably have subtle bugs lurking through your code where you're getting the wrong answers. And this is incredibly annoying. There are solutions. However, I have mocked up but not yet completed something like a non-promoting integer wrapper class that has all of these operator plus and everything implemented with proper overloads for us so that you can do all of these things and then never have to worry about getting these promotions that you don't want. And then you would end up with something like this. And you could use your own non-promoting uint8t type throughout your code base. And there's still some questions that I have about, you know, what happens if you add a uint8 with a uint16? Do we always want to return a 16? Do we not want to allow that and have to make it explicit for all of our use cases? I'm not entirely sure, but implementing this is an exercise for the reader. But if you don't implement it, your code's probably broken. So I suggest that you look into this and look for other safe integer types and non-promoting integer types that happen to exist. There are other libraries out there with complete versions of these. So good luck in fixing your integer arithmetic in your code, and be sure to subscribe.